Hello, everyone. My name is Stephen Phillips. I'm CTO of Theia Interactive, and I'm here to talk about a myriad of UE4 deliverables for a myriad of customer needs. Theia Interactive has been around for 5.5 years now as a visualization solutions company, almost exclusively working in Unreal Engine to solve a variety of customer problems. A lot of history in architecture and real estate and branching out into a variety of verticals. And we're here to talk about why we use Unreal Engine and use it for everything in the universe. So again, we are considering ourselves Unreal Engine experts. We are real-time rendering consultants. So when people have problems to solve and then they either know or they don't know that they need to be using real-time rendering, we work with them to come up with how to integrate Unreal Engine solutions into their workflow. For any given proposal or request for proposal that we get, it's always a question of how do we do this project in real time and what value add comes along with that. So the customer has requested XYZ deliverables. We know that by doing it with Unreal Engine, we can give them many, many more things. So how can we say, yes, we can do that and we can provide something else? By focusing all of our skills and attention on something like Unreal Engine, we have this really amazing, flexible team of developers where we take the same exact individuals to be doing architectural rendering or aerospace training, using the same exact skills for every single use case and every single thing that comes into our doors. Whether it's motion graphics in Unreal Engine or 3D rendering and lighting, we handle it all and we handle it with the same team of generalists. We got our start primarily in real estate. Some of our first clients, like Teso, Robles by Comstock Homes, wanted some innovative sales solutions. So they came to us in the early stages of a project, knowing that they needed a variety of marketing content, but primarily they wanted to have an iPad-based virtual tour solution where in a sales center they could walk people through the floor plans, show off the amenities and the general information about the community without actually having the community be built. And you could also send home any prospective client home with their own app to download on their own Android or iOS device from the App Store and actually walk through a home with their loved one and start discussing what it would be like to move into that place. And despite it being primarily an iPad-based virtual tour solution, we were also able to cover every single other aspect of their marketing needs. So from that same exact source content in the Unreal Engine scenes, we got them 60-plus 4K renders, 7 print-ready renders at a far higher resolution, and a 4K fly-through video of every single one of those floor plan options for the homes. So making the most out of the flexible deliverables from Unreal Engine. And we didn't bother to charge them per camera angle or per second of footage, because the bulk of our work was in creating the environments, putting together all the scenes and the lighting and creating the assets for the home tours. But the rendering cost was negligible once you have the content. So whether it's a 2K image or a 4K image or just waiting the extra minute to get a 4K fly-through, it was really all the same for us. So leveraging that content from the iPad, we were able to get them all this extra content, exterior renderings of the community, interiors, every single bathroom, every single room, multiple angles of everything. This community is actually built already, but they still continue to use our Unreal Engine renders from a few years ago on the website to this day, even though they have photographs right side by side with it. And despite it being optimized for an iPad Air 2 3 years ago, it's basically a mobile video game, it was still perfectly good to use as these interior fly-throughs for all of their marketing needs, a good enough quality to get them all the attention they wanted without all the extra cost of going to another studio to get their offline rendering stuff done. More recently, we've been working with Toll Brothers out of Philadelphia, and they are the nation's number one home builder of custom homes. So they care quite a bit about the quality of their construction and their design and the visual fidelity of that, which is why they chose us, and we chose Unreal Engine, of course. So we built out recently some homes tours for their new project in New York called Edge on Hudson, where you could, of course, walk through their virtual model homes for a couple floor plans, see all the variety of rooms and the multiple stories of the house, explore every angle, including the entire exterior courtyard, with all the foliage, and get the feel for what it'd be like to actually look out your window at the rest of the community. And again, we put in a lot of effort in building a virtual reality tour that they were using in their sales center to bring prospective clients through to put on the headset and go through this effort, but not everyone could make it to the sales center. Not everyone wants to put on the VR headset. So we took our cameras inside Unreal, and now they have this on the main website for the entire property. Really nice renderings with all the accurate reflections and an extremely high resolution. They even used these 8K renders for the print materials, extremely high resolution right out of Unreal Engine. And this was even before RTX was a thing as well. So again, the same content, the same source files, building real-time rendering interactive experiences, and yet using that for literally hundreds of renders across the different, you know, revisions that we gave them. But they ended up with 100 plus 4K renders of all these different intricate camera angles, 10 print ready, you know, specified renders at 8K, 4K video fly-throughs of each of the floor plans. And what really came out of this that was even more useful than we thought and looked really, really good was the 360 degree renders that we got out of Unreal. We used the NVIDIA Ansel plugin to more or less automate an entire home tour and stick it into a software solution called RoundMe, which is just a web-based 360 degree tour software where you can put pinpoints for where to jump across the house or where to put annotated comments about the features and amenities or embed other images. So instead of using virtual reality or using something that needs to run all the 3D software, they also got the static content that can be played on any device, in any web browser, anywhere in the world. For Bully and Andrews, they are building and designing a hospital. And for the newborn intensive care unit, they came to us requesting an interactive experience that was meant for training and informing all the staff about what the room would look like, the size constraints, and more importantly, how a lot of the appliances, the equipment, would fit into the room. So we modeled out a lot of the equipment that they would have, such as the beds and the heating lamps and a variety of cabinets. And users can grab and rearrange and rotate all of this equipment to see where it fits in the room and what the different, you know, handholds are, the line of sight, and the potential space constraints of what it would be like to be in this room. We also had interactivity, a little bit just for fun, of the different curtains that could be drawn back and forth for the breastfeeding area in the corner. And it was also used just for the designers to see where the different gas hoses were. And we went through several revisions on this based on their feedback of seeing it in virtual reality and making better choices about what it could look like and feel like. 2 years ago, here at Autodesk University, we actually partnered with Unreal Engine to create an augmented reality Harley-Davidson motorcycle experience. So the mission was to get a very dense CAD model put onto mobile AR, which was, you know, difficult to get at 60 frames a second. And that was to show off Unreal Engine's brand new AR kit support in Unreal Engine 4.18, I believe. So using the iPad, you could see an augmented reality motorcycle explode apart the engine and see every nut and bolt that was modeled by Amir Glinik. And we also had interactivity for changing the materials from being a rusty barn find to being a really shiny hot rod version of the bike. And despite it being designed as an iPad app, we were able to put it right into VR as well. Take our same exact UI that was on the mobile device, translate it to a 2D virtual reality controller, and get to see the bike from multiple angles across multiple platforms, on the desired, you know, need of whoever could use it. And for VR, we added an extra feature where you could grab a cross-section sphere and basically get an X-ray view of the entire bike. And again, it was an iPad app. It also just happened to be a VR app. And it also just happened to be content that we could make all these really high-end renders with as well. You just stick a camera up in there, get some depth of field, and suddenly you have marketing content. You have really nice renders using all the same textures and models that we were putting across these other platforms as well. So using the same cross-section material for the design review, we're able to get very interesting renders, very interesting close-ups of all the detail. And we were able to put it across all these different pieces of hardware just with levels of detail, essentially. So we have an aerospace client that we're doing some training and maintenance VR applications for. But we're looking to expand that client list and expand that capabilities. So we built this demo recently for NBAA last month, the aviation conference. It's on an augmented reality jet configurator, where you can put down a jet on your mobile device and see a couple animations here and there, get some informational pop-ups to give you more info on the different features of the engines and the cockpit and the range of flight, as well as configure the paint colors and the paint styles of where that the designs are being applied. And we actually showed this to that client who was having a hard time being sold on VR sales configurators. And they said, this is amazing. I need this right now, except I don't want it to be augmented reality. I just want it to be on a touchscreen. That's fine by me. Whether it's VR or AR or just 3D or even just the 2D renders of this, it's going to be the same amount of effort for my team with the same exact content and the same exact software. And this video just of the takeoff and landing animation got us nearly 500,000 views on Instagram and doubled our follower count in just a day. Turns out that anyone interested in aviation really wants their own toy virtual jet that they can fly around and show off to their friends and family. It's fun to just throw together these quick experiences. This augmented reality jet project was just 2 weeks, and it was like 1.5 people that worked on it. Because again, the same people who are putting together home tours are putting together jet configurators without any training or expertise in one industry or another. And taking that to a whole new extreme is Unreal Engine's great for the most amazing shiny objects and the most complex 3D meshes. We actually have a client that I can't name and I've blurred out the content here, but they came to us with a more traditional 2D request. So they had conferences coming up and they wanted an app that showed off different categories of research papers that they were publishing. And when they had that request, I remember sitting down with the team and trying to, you know, ask them, should we actually be making this in Unreal Engine? Should we send this off to some other company? Should we say no? But we built a 2D app all in the Unreal Engine, the Unreal Motion Graphics Editor, with pop-ups and text and reading all of this info from a spreadsheet that they were updating as they had new papers to publish. And we've revisited this multiple times for multiple trade shows for them. In fact, the same client came to us with a website that already existed and they just wanted it bundled into a standalone app. They didn't want to go to a trade show and have people messing around with a web browser. So we used Unreal Engine to just produce a single app whose only purpose was to load a web page in the web browser of the Unreal Motion Graphics. And that was the funniest use of Unreal Engine for us. You'd think that Unreal Engine would be just too good to waste on being a web browser, but that's the beauty of Unreal, is it kind of does everything. So again, we use Unreal Engine for everything, whether the client only wants 2D renders, or they only want 3D interactivity, or they only want stills, or they only want video. Anything and everything, we're always looking for ways to use Unreal Engine and real-time rendering. I gave a talk at SIGGRAPH this year on the concept of the convergence of two domains of design and marketing. Design being more iterative and low quality and meant for fast, you know, throwing together of stuff, which has traditionally been a real-time rendering concept, and marketing being final pixel, perfect quality end user content. And typically you'd find that on the design side of things, there's really simple graphics, you know, it's a viewport of a 3D modeling software. And on the marketing side, you send off the same content to different software to be rendered in a different way, to be consumed by different means. So there's a lot of different deliverables across these two domains and a lot of different software that's been used across these two domains. But we've been lucky enough to be growing up right in the middle of these two fields focused on things like Unreal Engine, where for any given purpose, whether it's a fast iteration and a low visual quality, or the highest end pixel perfect, you know, Super Bowl commercials, it can all be done with something like Unreal Engine. So despite, I mean, for any request that comes in, even from visual effects to the most basic real estate tour, we're always looking to Unreal Engine to define what we're doing and encountering both super simple usages and advanced usages and things that take a couple weeks and things that take an entire year, all focusing that on one team using one piece of software for a nearly infinite amount of deliverables. So that's us at Theia Interactive. We're actually here all week at the HP booth. We have our own Unreal Engine pipeline solution called Optum, which is meant to automate some of the tedious parts of the data prep process for getting content into Unreal Engine. We've been using that ourselves for our own projects like you've seen up here. And we're also available for other consulting and services work around Unreal Engine or real-time rendering applications. So thanks for listening. I'll be around right after.